So today we'll discuss about specific heat of a substance. The substance can be solid, liquid or gas. To start with, in general, we'll discuss about specific heat of a substance. Then we'll go for in the next video the specific heat of a gas. Specific heat means if we take a substance, okay, if we take a substance and 1 gram of a substance and you heat it to raise its temperature, if its temperature increases through 1 degree centigrade, exactly 1 degree centigrade, the amount of heat supplied to do so is called as specific heat of that substance. That means it is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of a substance through 1 degree centigrade. Okay. This is the definition of specific heat. It's the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of a substance through 1 degree centigrade. Unit mass, it might be gram, it might be kilogram, but a unit value. That means if I have a substance like, say, I will take a piece of iron, its temperature is now say 20 degree centigrade. I supply heat, its temperature will rise to 21 degree centigrade. So whatever amount of heat that I have applied, that is known as a specific heat. The symbol we are using is C. So the heat that is supplied here to exactly do the same thing is known as a specific heat. So the heat is called the specific heat. Now therefore the explanation part will have the expression for this specific heat. That specific heat is the heat required, heat that is supplied per unit mass per delta theta, I'll write here. That Q or delta Q, I'll say, no problem whether I write Q or theta or delta Q, delta theta, it doesn't matter much. The heat, this amount of heat that is required, this is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of substance through 1 degree centigrade. So this is the formula actually we are using, that C is equal to delta Q by m delta 3. This is the heat supplied, this is the change in temperature, this is the mass of the substance. This is a specific heat. So basically, the amount of heat supplied is directly proportional to the mass and the rising temperatures. More the mass, you have to supply more the heat to raise the temperature, and to increase the temperature by large amount, you have to supply more amount of heat. That means we have the dQ factor, this is the heat that is supplied, dQ, is directly proportional to the mass and the change in temperature. So, if more mass is there, more heat is required to change temperature, and if you increase the temperature by more amount, you have to supply more heat. That means these two are related like this. So, if I write a proportionality constant, some constant, m delta theta, so here this is known as a specific heat. Okay, specific heat is the amount of heat that is needed to raise the temperature of unit mass of substance. Because if I divide this by here and here, that will give me the heat supplied corresponding to the unit mass and unit temperature rise. So the unit of unit of C. The unit of C is a unit of Q or dQ, whatever you say, unit of M and unit of theta. This is heat, this is temperature, this is mass. Therefore, this is in SI system, joule per kilogram Kelvin. So, it is joule. This is the SI unit. This is also expressed in joule per kilogram degree centigrade. This unit is also used. So, this is a unit of C. Okay. And this is how you define specific heat. Specific heat is the heat by M delta theta. This formula you use. That specific heat is the heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of substance through 1 degree centigrade. Okay. Thank you.